And we've only begun to scratch the surface of what's possible in this market that we're co-creating together. And most of all, I want to thank you so much for your inspiration.
Please welcome Coupa Chief Marketing Officer, Chandar Pattabhiram.
Let's rock and roll.
Here we go. Morning. Welcome to day two. We're going to rock and roll today. What a great day one yesterday. You know, Rob kicked it off with pizza. And if you think about it, it's a great connection to start a spend management conference with pizza, because after all, both of them are all about the dough. So we had a great start with pizza. But quickly, you know, Rob went to showcase the pizzazz of this community by showcasing all the great attributes of our leaders and then shared our expanding BSM vision. And it was great to see Malcolm Gladwell talk about and reminding us thoughtfully about the fact that, you know, we're only as strong as our weakest link. And then we had some great partner and customer sessions yesterday. Today, we have an equally terrific day two for you. I'm going to kick it off with some thoughts, and then I'm going to invite my esteemed colleagues, Raja Hamood and Ravi Thakur, who are going to come and share all the exciting new innovation that's been inspired by this community. And then we have an all-star lineup for today. Susie Orman is here, and she's going to be inspiring us by talking about the connection between how we can spend smarter in our personal lives and how that can make us to do the same in our professional lives. And the world-renowned Deepak Chopra is also here, and he's going to be inspiring us with a talk on the future of well-being and how can we be more mindful and how can we be more live a fuller life in our daily lives today. And then tonight, we're going to go back to the 90s with our dancing shoes, Steve Argeri with Journey, Tone Loc, Vanilla Ice, and Sir Mix-a-Lot. Now you got to give it. Where else but Coupa Inspire are you going to see Deepak Chopra and Sir Mix-a-Lot on the same slide on the same day? So exciting, exciting day ahead. And I want to kick off today going back to the year 1911, to one of the most beautiful cities in Europe, Prague. And what you see here is the Café Louvre. And the Café Louvre in that time in 1911 was becoming a center for a vibrant community of intellectuals. Famous names would get together every day, share ideas, and inspire each other with their stories. Now, it so turned out that that community at the cafe, those luminaries at the Louvre, was responsible for one of the greatest scientific achievements in human history. You fast forward 5 years to the year 1916, Albert Einstein unleashed upon us the general theory of relativity, and gave us the story of our universe and its three profound forces, gravity, space, and time. It's interesting that Einstein himself said that his greatest achievement would not have been possible if not for the time he spent at the Café Louvre, getting inspired by all those stories from those luminaries that he interacted with. It's interesting that Einstein only spent 16 months in Prague, but the fact that he credited this community shows the impact and the power of that community. Simply put, the gravitas of that community helped Einstein explain gravity for all of us. Now, if I shift from science to art, and that's the Impression Sunrise, one of the world's greatest paintings by Monet. Now, Impressionism, to take a Malcolm Gladwell turn from yesterday, was the tipping point in art history and paved the way for the modern art era and gave birth to the modern art era. Impressionists, what they did by nature, they stopped trying to depict paintings that reflected reality. Now, photography could do that. Instead, as you can see, they focused on storytelling through the senses. But we never would have heard of Monet or any of the great Impressionist artists if not for the power of the community. Renault, Monet, and a number of artists got together to form this community of art rebels, to fight the status quo, to defy the critics of the time, and create a movement that changed the entire art history. So with these two examples of science and art, folks, it's interesting. History is a funny thing. It recognizes and tends to remember a number of great individuals, the Renaults and the Monets and the Einsteins. But behind them, there's a strong community coming together in unity to inspire them with these shared stories, experiences, and ideas. If you really break down the word community, that's really what it means. Communication in unity and coming together. And what's exciting for me is that in our community, in our business management community, there are some great stories. But when we put all these stories together in unity, it becomes that much more powerful. In fact, when we take the stories of our community in unity, it becomes the story of life. Let me explain. Can you play the video, please?
We're born. We grow. We play and learn. We love and marry. We heal and cure. We care and protect. We work and save. We invest and ensure. We dress to look our best. We clean and organize. We eat and drink. We snack and sip. We ship and shop. We spin and stretch. We drive and fly. We Google and Snap and Slack. We run and ski and cheer and fish and paint and party and craft and read and watch and listen. We age, we grieve, we live. Stories that power our lives. That's the story of our BSM community.
Give it up for yourself. There's some great stories in this community. And that's what it is. Stories make up communities. Without stories, there are no communities. It's the tales that make the tribe. So these stories are important to share. And how do we share these stories? Well, it starts with great storytellers. And we have some fantastic storytellers in our community. We call them the Spendsetters. And as you can see, they're leaders who upend the status quo, break convention, create new paths, and most importantly, inspire all of us with their stories. And as we have walked the hallways this week, we've been honored to profile 15 great Spendsetters. Rob shared some of their attributes. They come from different backgrounds, different environments, different companies. Well, what's common is that each one has a unique trait that plays a role in the unique tale that they say. So let me share some stories of these Spendsetters. First, Rick Quaintance from USO. Now, Rick has a great businessman management story. Now, USO is an organization that provides support and services to the great troops of our nation. Now, Rick inherited an organization that was completely on paper. Invoices were snail-mailed across the country. Lots and lots of invoices sat on desks on big stacks, on post-it notes, and a lot of times were paid late or never paid. So he took an organization like that, and he digitally transformed it. Unified it in one businessman management platform, and you go from a complete paper organization to more than 90% paperless invoicing. And what Rick also did is leverage the collective power of this community. He leveraged the collective intelligence, the community intelligence of this community, and benchmark himself in his invoice cycle times against those of the community, and saw that he was 7x slower. He used this intelligence to spend smarter, and as you can see, he's reduced his invoice cycle time to just 1.8 days. Now, that's a great businessman management story. But what makes Rick a great storyteller is that he's telling a story beyond the boundaries of businessman management. Rick is telling a story of getting food, furniture, phone calls, and all the services that the American troops need faster than ever before. He's telling a story of what his team directly does, directly impacts lives in America. For example, Hurricane Harvey, 2 years ago, in Texas, 3,000 of the Texas National Guard was deployed to save families in Texas, and USO's mobile units were supporting them, and they needed to get the food and supplies to the US troops on time. And this is where the speed, the agility, the innovation that Rick and his team introduced directly impacted here. so that the USO's mobile units were now instantly approving the stuff that was got the stuff that they needed approved instantly, rather than waiting for a week to do that. And the impact and the result is the troops got what they needed and saved those lives. Now, ensuring customer success is our number one core value here at Coupa, and there is no better example of ensuring customer success than what Rick and his team are doing. The impact was so great and the story was so good that Rick and his team are awarded the USO's President's Medal for Organization Change. Let's give it up for Rick and his team for being a part of this community. Another great storyteller, Gary Foster from Highmark Health. Now, Highmark is a $20 billion health and wellness organization. And Gary has a great businessman management story. He's a transformative leader. And he has taken transformed category management with a maniacal focus on customer intimacy. So he started an initiative called Increasing Strategic Participation with Clients, where every member of his team has a mindset to be a consultant, immerse himself or herself in the internal client's business, understand the challenges, understand the opportunities, and be a trusted advisor to provide the solutions they need, both in terms of process, technology, and change. And you see the result for Gary and his team? They've got 90% PO dollars sent electronically. They were at 45% before, and now they're at 90%, more than 100% increase there, and a whopping 625% ROI savings with his departmental budget. Now, that's a great businessman management story. But again, what makes Gary a great storyteller is he's telling the story beyond the boundaries of his daily function. Gary tells the story of Highmark Health's promise to be a catalyst for innovative change that is transforming healthcare in America. He tells a story of how can we bring a retail experience to healthcare in America. For example, when we have a retail experience in all of us, we don't have to go seek out for our shopping experience. It's said today, it comes to us directly right next to us. Why can't we do the same thing in healthcare? He tells a story of where rather than just going to hospitals when we're sick, why can't health and wellness come to us in our daily lives? How do they do that? Well, Gary and his team are right at the forefront for fostering the right relationships with the device manufacturers in such a way that Highmark can provide these health and wealth solutions right in a smartphone next to us. Now, that's a great story. The World Procurement Congress had 900 submissions for the Procurement Executive of the Year. So great was the impact of Gary's transformative change story that they recognized him as the Worldwide Procurement Executive of the Year this year. Ladies and gentlemen, Gary Foster. Gary, we're proud to have him part of this community. Thank you, Gary. And then there's Procter & Gamble, one of the most iconic brands in America. My 85-year-old mom in India knows a lot about this brand. Now, April and her team at P&G have a great businessman management story at scale. And Rob talked about this yesterday, $50 billion of spend processed through the system and 5 million invoices. So lots of scale there. When April and team took over, originally, they had millions of invoices, and 24% of those invoices were getting blocked due to data mismatch issues. And it took them 24% to 20% for many years before April and her team began their transformation journey as part of this community. And in 1 year, they've gone from 20% to 7% and reduced their PO cycle times from days to hours. And the result, when you put it all together, $2.5 billion in savings. Now, that's a great businessman management story. Again, what makes April a great storyteller is that she tells a story beyond her daily function. In fact, she gets on a roll when she tells the story because it touches all of us in a very special place. She tells the story of the forever roll. Now, it so turns out that we all don't like running out of toilet paper. And P&G realized that it has an innovation lab that flushes out a number of new ideas. And they came up with this forever roll to solve the problem. But what they realized is that when they introduced it, they saved such a big hit, they saw much more than they expected. But they also had to source the stand for it to provide the complete solution. They didn't have a formal supply chain process for it. Now, here's when April and her team stepped in, drove the sourcing process for the stand to provide in rapid agility, in speed, to provide the complete solution so that customers are really happy that P&G has got their back. So that is, again, a story beyond the daily functions of our job. Now, the pattern, folks, that you see, the pattern from all these three stories, that story wrote for all of them is at the intersection of being interesting and meaningful. Interesting to capture our attention, and meaningful to showcase the impact in a more epic way than the daily lives. We all need to do that, because we have a lot of interesting and meaningful things that we're doing in our daily lives, in our functions. So what we need to do is get these stories out. Get the Spielberg out of us, get these stories from our jaws, and share it to the community. So at this conference, I ask you two things. Number one, look at somebody next to you in our community. Look to your left, look to your right. We all have interesting stories. Listen to their stories, share your stories. Let's have close encounters of the first kind. Second, go visit us in the expo hall. In the end, there's a Coupa Champions booth, and there is a story team there. If you have a story you'd like to say, give it to us, and we'll be honored to bring it to life. And third, just remember, stories@coupa.com. Send us an email, and we'll do the same to bring your stories to life, stories@coupa.com. So that's my story of the day, and that's my ask of all of you. As I end, I'm really, really excited to leave you with something that is an annual tradition for us at Coupa. Our annual dance video featuring our employees at Coupa and the extended community. Coupa and the community, the CNC Music Factory. Here is the video. Enjoy it. I'll see all of you on the dance floor tonight. Thank you.
Shake your pants, take a chance. Come on and dance, guys. Grab a girl, don't wait, make the twirl. It's your world and I'm just a squirrel. Trying to get a nut to move your butt to the dance floor. So yo, what's up? Hands in the air. Come on, say yeah. Everybody over here, everybody over there. The crowd is live and I will do this too. Party people in the house, move. We'll be right back. you sweat till you bleed. Is that dope enough? Indeed, I paid the price to control the dice. I'm more precise to the point I'm nice.